Hello, this is Mansi and I'm currently pursuing my 7th semester of Information Science Engineering from B&M Institute of Technology, Bangalore. In this video, I will be demonstrating a mini project called as Vehicle Rental Website, which I have done under the course of Cloud Computing and its application under the guidance of Jamuna S. Murthy ma'am. In this video, I will be covering a brief introduction to the project, the cloud platform that I have used for deployment, the objectives, the methodologies, a summary, and a brief demo of the project. Let me start with the introduction. The vehicle rental website mainly aims at providing the users way to book a vehicle like car, bike, etc. on rent at the fair charges. The aim of the mini project was to automate the entire work that is performed in a rental company, like keeping records of vehicles available for booking, rental charges for vehicles provided by using a Heroku cloud platform. Vehicle rental website provides a complete solution to all the day-to-day activities that is to be done in a rental company. It is a unique and innovative product using which the administrator can keep the information of the rentals available. Based on this information, he can take decisions regarding the business development, the promotional offerings, and etc. Heroku Cloud Platform is a platform as a service model supporting several programming languages. Heroku was developed in the year 2007 June. When it was developed, it only supported Ruby programming language, but now it supports Java, Node.js, Scala, Python, PHP, Go. For this reason, Heroku is said to be a polyglot platform, as it has features for a developer to build, run, and scale applications in a similar manner across most languages. Heroku was acquired by Salesforce.com in 2010. The applications that run on Heroku typically have a unique domain used to route the HTTP request to the correct application container. Each of these containers are spread across a dyno grid, which consists of several servers. Heroku's Git server handles applications repository pushes from the permitted users. Now let's talk about the objectives. The main objective was to promote the rental vehicle industry and give a competitive alternative with new and innovative promotional offerings. It also helps the commuters and the companies to save time, effort, and money of owning and maintaining their own vehicles. It also provides mobility services with accuracy, safety, and care at a very competitive price. Since data is centralized on the cloud, it is easy for the administrators to update the details, which overcomes the tedious updation issues. Maintenance is easy and performance is good. Mainly, the system automates the entire vehicle renting process. Now let's come to the methodologies that have been followed. With Heroku account created and the Heroku tool built installed, we can start on with the development of our application. The first step to be followed was to create an app folder in a specified path in the command line interface. Then we have to log into the Heroku via the terminal, create a test.php file, create a composer, establish a Git repository, create the Heroku project, deploy the application by connecting to your Git directory, and then commit the files using the Git command. After committing the files, you can push all your deployment applications to the Git repository, to the Heroku project. Now, after this, we set up the database configuration. In this project, I have used a remote MySQL and a MySQL Workbench remote connection to connect to the backend database. Coming to the summary, to summarize everything that I have explained till now, the vehicle rental website is hosted using the Heroku cloud platform using remote MySQL server. The website developed provides the commuters and the companies to save time, effort, and money of owning and maintaining owned vehicles. Since it is hosted on the cloud, maintenance is easy and the administrators can update the details very easily and the performance is really good. It has automated the entire process of vehicle renting. The website helps promote the vehicle industry and gives a competitive alternative with a new and innovative promotional offerings. Now let's dive into the demo of the project. This is the Heroku dashboard page, which contains my project HireRide. I have deployed it through my GitHub directory. I have connected my GitHub repository to the Heroku cloud platform and deployed it using a manual deploy. This is the remote MySQL page where I have created a remote database with a username, and I have uploaded all my database information to the remote MySQL database that I have created. This is my MySQL workbench, which I have connected to my remote SQL database, which has the tables admin, cars, client, hire, and message. This is the homepage of my website, which is called as HireRide. And this is the rent page, which contains the list of all the vehicles that are available for renting. This is the contact us page, which contains the message admin here dialog box, wherein you can enter your message and send to the admin, and also contains the footer with about us, terms, policies, and about the company with the social media handles. This is the client login page, wherein the client can sign up here if he's a new user using his credentials, name, phone number, with the email address, the ID number, and the location, and submit the details. Once he successfully registered, he will be taken to the login page again, wherein he can log in with his credentials. Then he's taken to the rent page, wherein he can rent any of the vehicles. Now I will rent a Land Rover. I click to book. I give a payment transaction ID and my DL number and submit the details to the admin and wait for the admin approval. I can view my status here, wherein the booking status is pending since the client has requested for the approval, but the admin is yet to approve the request. I can message the admin saying that please approve and send a message. Now I will show the admin part of it. This is the admin login page, wherein I log in with the credentials. Once I log in, this is the admin dashboard, which contains the client messages, the vehicle management, and the hire request pages. In the hire request page, here is the recent request that I have made for a Range Rover, and the status is pending since I am yet to approve it. If I want to delete it, I can delete it. If I want to approve it, I can approve it. Now I will approve his request. The request has been successfully approved. Now I log in as a client again and see the status of my booking. If I see the status of my booking, it comes as approved, since my booking status was approved by my admin. Now let me show you the admin features. I log in again as an admin here. If I log in as an admin, I have the dashboard, which contains the client messages, a vehicle management page, which contains the list of vehicles that are available for the rental. The admin can delete any of the vehicles if they are not available at that time, and add new vehicles using the name, the hire price, and images along with the capacity. And the hire request page contains the request of the clients with the client phone number, the vehicles, the amount, and the status. If the administration needs to delete any of the previous requests of the clients, he can delete it, or the admin can keep the records as it is. Now I log out. If I log out of the admin page, I return back to the home page. The home page again contains the list of all the vehicles along with the social media handles and about us details. In this way, I have deployed my vehicle rental website on a cloud platform called as Heroku. Heroku is a very interactive and helpful cloud platform as a service model, which helped me to deploy my vehicle rental website. The vehicle rental website is now being an innovative project that can be used by any rental companies for managing their orders and help them increase their business by promotional offerings. I hope you liked this video. Thank you.